Today is Rosh Chodesh. Layhudim, layhudim, hayta ora, v'simcha, v'sason, v'kar. Rabotai, today, the Rosh Chodesh Adar, we say, when Rosh Chodesh Adar come, we have to increase simcha. You have to be happy. What's special on Purim? On Adar. Understand on Purim, we have to be b'simcha, to say thank you to Hashem for all the miracles that He did with us, with that Haman, he wanted to kill the Jews, and Baruch Hashem, he did not kill the Jews, Baruch Hashem, and we approach, we did a big teshuvah, and we did, and Baruch Hashem, we respected the Torah, we accepted the Torah again. Of course, the Torah was given on Matan Torah, but on Purim, we saw, the Jews saw how much Hashem, He loved us. I mean, all the history of Purim, it's Megillah. Megillah, that means the history of Purim, all what happened to us, it was at the beginning, no one was knowing what's going to happen. And suddenly, one morning we woke up, we saw, you know, papers, big information that Hamas declared war to the Jews. Shock, a big shock that remind me when during the Shoah, a lot of times people woke up in the morning and they saw the German soldiers outside and killing Jews. And they were preparing Jews. They give them only 3 hours to prepare themselves to catch the train to Auschwitz. Exactly that's what happened. One morning came and suddenly look what happened. They saw, you know, announcement in the walls that the Jews are going to be killed on the 14th of Adar. What a disaster. And Baruch Hashem, in a few days, Hashem canceled the gezeirah of Haman, and Haman was hung, and his children was hung, and Lehudim hayta ora v'simcha v'sason v'kar. He said that. Okay. But the question is, why, I mean, all the time, we had this kind of situations. Not only on the month of Adar. You know, we saw a lot of miracles like that. Why, I mean, why we don't say this for Nisan? Le'ehudim, hayta ora v'simcha v'sason v'kar, and the month of Sivan. I mean, for me, the month of Sivan is Matan Torah. The month of Nisan was the miracles that, you know, Nisan, it's named Nisan from the word Nes, the big Nisim that Hashem He showed us before we went out from Egypt. I mean, we saw a lot of miracles. Why Adar, like the only month in the year that we say that we have to be happy, Adar, the month of Adar. Like, Why other? There was no generation there was not one somebody who wanted to kill the Jews. If you read a little bit stories about what happened during all our history, a lot of times we've been condemned to death, and at the end of Kosh Baruch Hu, we did the big miracle. And we don't do a special happiness on that month. No. So why Adar? Maybe Nisan, the month of our liberation. Yes. Maybe Iyar is the month of the refuah. Yeah, it's Ani Hashem of Echa. Yeah. Maybe Sivan. Yes, why not? Maybe Iyah Tammuz and Av. Even that those 2 months are a bad month, but we have a promise from Hashem that we will be liberated. So, it's a good, imagine somebody who's not well, and the doctor promised him that Be'ezat Hashem, he will be cured, he'll be happy. So every year we'll celebrate the month that the doctor give him the good news. Why not Elul and Tishrei, they are the month of Teshuvah, the month of forgiveness. Yes, no, Hashem, the rabbi said, Adar. What is his Adar? My friend, what it is special on Adar, when Adar come, we have to increase the joy, we have to increase the simcha, Ivdut Hashem b'simcha. Why Adar? I am Baruch Hashem, I read a lot of stories, and I know a lot of stories. Look, there is a story about the Maharal Prague. There was there a bad man that he wanted that the whole Jews would be killed. So what he did, he killed a baby. And he took the blood of the baby and he hid it on the Hechal, where there is a Sefer Torah. And so the non-Jew, they will search for the... At that time, just to say that the Jews, they do the matzot with the blood of a goy. I mean, you know, we're not allowed to eat blood, especially a blood of a person. I mean, it's crazy. But that was alilat dam. It was a way how to kill the Jews. You know, it was just to accuse them that the Jews killed people to make matzot with the blood of their children. And that night, it was a big mess. That night, something happened. That they saw, the Maharal Miprag, his mother, she was pregnant of him. So they went out to call the lady, you know, the nurse, to help the mother of the Maharal Miprag for the delivery of the baby. And at that moment, you know what happened? They saw a man throwing a body of a baby. So quick, what they did, they took the baby, it was killed. So they understood that some non-Jew, they did that, so they will accuse the Jews that they killed the baby to bake the matzot. So they took the body and they put it in the house of somewhere outside the ghetto. So in the middle of the night, all the city of Prague, they came to search the houses, house to house of the Jews, if they found the body. And Baruch Hashem didn't find it. And that happened Erev Pesach. So you see, all our life we had Nisim. All our life we had big Nisim. So what special on the Nes of Adar? All the time we had people that they wanted to kill the Jews. And we did nothing for them. My friend, you know what it is, the Nes of Adar? That's why we said, Mishi Nechnas Adar Mabi Bisimha. The real Nes, it's not that Haman didn't kill the Jews. The Nes is that we receive back our identity. You know, in the Megillah, we mentioned all the time, O Mordechai Ayodi, Mordechai the Jew. Did you ask a question to yourself, where you saw in the whole histories of the Jewish people that somebody would call him Jew, Mordechai Yehudi? I saw all the Torah, I didn't see a man that we call him Yehudi. Today we call us Yehudim. Yehudim is Jewish. But we never saw in no book that we call somebody Mordechai the Jew, or David the Jew, or Shlomo the Jew, or Yeremiah the Jew, or Yeshaya the Jew. Why Mordechai? You know why? Because at that moment, that generation of Mordechai and Esther, people were ashamed to call themselves they are Jewish. The Jewish were assimilated. Even the Kohen Gadol, Yeshua Kohen Gadol, his children, they were married to non-Jewish girls. Can you imagine that? Why? After the Beit HaMikdash was destroyed, and the Jewish people, they were in Persian, Madai, Paras, they were Babel, you know, they were in exile, because Nebuchadnezzar, Nebuchadnezzar, when he destroyed the Beit HaMikdash, he killed a lot of Jewish people, and the remaining Jews, they took them in exile, he spread them all over the world. So they started to be assimilated. They were ashamed to say they are Jewish. Mordechai was the only one, Mordechai Yehudi. Mordechai proclaimed himself to everybody that he is Jewish. And he started to do a revolution against Haman. Haman, the king Ahasuerus, he gave an order to give him kavod, to give him glory, to kiss his hand, to bend to him, and he had idolatry in his chest, Avodah Zarah. That means he wanted to force the Jew to recognize there is Avodah Zarah. There is no God, there is no Hashem, there is only Avodah Zarah. And you know what Mordechai did? He would not bend in front of him. He was an example toward the Jews. That I am Jewish. I will not hide my identity. I am a Ben Torah. I love Torah. I know only Hashem. I will not bend to Avodah Zarah. I will bend only to Hashem. That was the miracle, my friend. That's what we should always remember. O Mordechai Hayudi, Mordechai the Jew. That is all Purim about. Purim, it was the month of Adar. Adar, it's the month of Moshe Rabbeinu pass away. Moshe Rabbeinu, he did not pass away. He's always alive. Moshe Emet, v'Torato Emet. The same way that the Torah, she's alive. It's still, up to now, already about 4,000 years, a little bit less than 4,000 years since we received the Torah. Baruch Hashem, we respect the Torah. The Torah was given by who? By Moshe Rabbeinu. He received it where? In Har Sinai. Haman, he wanted to show the Jews there is no Torah, there is no God, there is nothing, there is no Moshe, nothing. Moshe passed away, he died. He took with him all his story, there is nothing. Moshe died on the month of Adar, the 7th of Adar. So for Haman, well, after the Goral he did, he took papers, he wrote on each paper the month of each month, and then he took one paper, Adar. Ah, Adar is good, because on Adar, Moshe, the rabbi, passed away, died. He died, the Torah died. So now that there is no Torah, there is no Moshe to protect them, there is no God. And beside this, Moshe, this is very, very good that you should know, Moshe, if you take the letter of Moshe, the Baal HaTorim said, Moshe is the same letters of Hashem. Moshe, Moshe is the same letters of Hashem. So that means Hashem doesn't exist. God forbid. You know, my friend? Haman came to Ahasuerus. He told him, Ahasuerus, you love me? Of course I love you. If I ask you something to do, you will do it. I will do everything you want. I give you half of my kingdom. You are my second. What do you need? You know, the Jewish people, we don't need them. They are thief. They are not united. They are strange. And anyway, their God, he abandoned them. And beside their God, he's an old man. He's old. He cannot protect them. So don't worry. That's why tomorrow it's Parashat Shkalim. He said, I give you 10,000 shekel for, I want to buy them from you. Because the Jewish people, when they had the Beit HaMikdash, they used to bring Shkalim. But now there is no Beit HaMikdash. There is no Shkalim. And to give to the Beit HaMikdash. And besides this, there is no, their God is old. They have no Beit HaMikdash. They are now abandoned. They are in exile. We don't need them. Their religion is strange. They are not united. Let's finish with them. I want to prove you that they are nothing. And no one, as long as they are alive, they threaten us with their history. We should kill them so that we'll prove the world their history is finished. And Ahasuerus accepted the proposition because he thought maybe he's right. But Mordechai HaYehudi, the big believer, he said, impossible. Moshe Emet, Vetorato Emet. The same way that Moshe, he is Emet, and his story is Emet, Hashem, the name of Hashem is mentioned on the name of Moshe. Hashem, he was before the creation of the world, and he's still, and he will be. So, all what we need, we have to show this Haman that we have to go face to face against him. We have to put him face to the wall to prove him that Hashem is Emet, is not an old man, God forbid. The Torah is Emet, the Torah is the names of the Hashem. And Am Yisrael is Emet, and the Torah is Emet, Moshe Emet. So he said to the Jews, do like me, O Mordechai HaYehudi, all the problems that you have only because you deny Hashem, you deny the Torah. You are not happy to be Jew. So now Haman is looking for you. Like Hitler. You know, Hitler, he killed people that even that they were not Jewish. So they told him, but he's Catholic. He said, but his father is Jew. His name is Cohen, Schwarz. Yeah, but he's not Jewish because his mother, she's Catholic. And beside this, he go to the church. No, he has a Jewish name. So Haman, that's what he wanted to do. The same like Hitler. And Mordechai said, let's show to Haman that Hashem Emet, Moshe Emet, Torato Emet, and Am Yisrael Emet. How? Declare our identity. Declare our love to Hashem. Do Teshuvah. Declare that we love the Torah. And you will see, everything will be good. That's what happened, my friend. That's why, my friend, this month of Adar, Mishinichnas Adar, Marbi Bisimha. When the month of Adar starts, we have to increase joy. Why? Because on Adar, we remember what we lost on those times, our Jewish identity, the Torah, our connection to Hashem, Tfilot, pray to Hashem. And what they did? He prayed so hard to Hashem. They did a big teshuvah. They started to put kippah on their head. And Haman was shocked. He saw the Jewish people now that since he declared to destroy them, to finish with them, the last solution is the 14th of Adar to kill all of them. So the lady started to do teshuvah. Who was the one who led them to all this? Mordechai. So let's start killing Mordechai right away. Not waiting next year to kill him. Right away. And when he decided to kill Mordechai right away, so Esther, she invites Ahasuerus with Haman two nights, and she was Esther, she wanted to make jealous the king. She was giving drinks to Haman. She was talking to him nicely. So Haman, he thought he was the best. And my friend Haman, he went to his house happy. But Ahasuerus, he couldn't sleep. He was jealous. He was jealous of the one that he loved so much. Haman. Maybe there is something between him and his wife. Jealousy. And Esther, she did it on purpose to make the king jealous. And the second night, she told him, now you want to know why I invite this man? Yes, tell me. Why you invited this man twice? I never saw this in my life, that you invited somebody. Now you invite him twice. Why? Because this man, he wants to kill my people. He's a bad man. So she told him who was she? She was Jewish. She was from the family of the King Shaul. So Ahasuerus was shocked when he saw that he's married to a Jewish woman. And she's from the descendant of the king, Shaul. And of course, everybody knows the history of the King Shaul. Hashem said to Shaul to kill all the Amalekim. And he didn't kill the Amalekim. And because he didn't kill all the Amalekim, Haman came. Instead of that, Haman will be nice to the Jewish people. Because Shaul didn't kill all the Amalekim. Haman, he wanted to kill the whole Jews. So Ahasuerus said, this man, he don't recognize the good things that they did with him. If you want to do that, if you want to kill the Jews, that they didn't kill him, they didn't kill his parents 2,000 years ago, maybe he can do the same to me. So let's kill him before you do bad things to me. That is, Rabotai, the miracle of the miracles. The miracle, it's not physic. The miracle that we had back our identity through the physic, through Haman, our Jewish identity. We discovered that the Torah is Emet, Moshe Emet, Vitorato Emet, and Hashem love us. That's why all this happened in the month of Adar. That's why we, in the month of Adar, we gained our identity. And because we gained our Jewish identity in the month of Adar, so the month of Adar, it become the best month of all years, of all the month. Because on Adar, we had everything. Because if each month we had something, but on the month of Adar, we had everything, complete. On Nisan, we had our liberation, okay. On Iyar, we had the Refuah, okay. On Sivan, we had the Torah, okay. But etc., etc. Elul and Tishri, we did Teshuvah, Hashem forgive us. Très bien, okay. But in the month of Adar, we did Teshuvah, we received the Torah, Ahdut, we were united, we connect ourselves to Hashem, we couldn't achieve to the tzaddikim. So we had back our Jewish identity, and we were delivered. So everything that way is the best month. The month of Adar represents all the 11 months. So Bishinichlas Adar Marbim Bisimcha. And the month of Adar, it has another thing, particular thing. You know what? Because Amalek become very strong in the month of Adar. The Kuach of Amalek. Because Shaul, he didn't kill him. He didn't finish with Amalek. So Amalek, he has a big Kuach on the month of Adar. How can we reduce his strength? By happiness, by joy, by recognizing all the good things that Hashem did with us. So we make him weak, very weak. You know, my friend, when you are happy, the happiness destroys the doubt. When somebody has a doubt, he's not happy. But when there is no doubt, you are happy. If you have a doubt, if you want the lotto or not, you are not happy. You don't know. But when you have no doubt, you have the confirmation that you want the lotto, oh, so you are happy. So my friend, on the month of Adar, all the doubt that we had about our Jewish identity, about loving Hashem, about loving the Torah, everything went away. That's it. Finished. So what? And we were so much connected to Hashem, so the happiness was very, very big. This is, my friend, the what we should learn from this day today, Rosh Chodesh. And don't forget one thing. The big mistake of Haman, he thought the month of Adar, Moshe died. No, don't forget. The tzaddikim, even that they die, they become more stronger. The tzaddikim are more stronger after the death, more than they were alive. Because where they're alive, they were here. But once they die, they're in front of Hashem. They're next to Hashem. So that, you know, my friend, when a tzaddik pass away, that they become billion times more stronger than he was alive. So that's why, my friend, today, the month of Adar, we have to be million times more happiest than before. Because in this month of Adar, we have all the pipelines, all the tzinorot of Shefa, all the big the holy pipelines are opened for us in the month of Adar. Everything is open. Even if you have a court, it's good to have it on the month of Adar because it's a good month. A lot of times they ask me, and then I finished. It's funny that we don't do a Hilula of Moshe Rabbeinu. It's very funny. We do Hilula of Tzadikim. But the Hilula of Moshe Rabbeinu, we don't do it. Why? We should do the Hilula of Moshe Rabbeinu, Aaron, David HaMelech. No, we do only Hilula of some Tzadikim. Not, I mean, Moshe Rabbeinu is the... We should do a celebration of Moshe Rabbeinu. You know why we don't do it? Because every day that we study Torah, it's a Hilula. When you study Torah, you are happy. When you serve Hashem, Evdo et Hashem b'simcha, serving Hashem with joy. So every day it's Hilula. When today, I was doing my Daf HaYomi today, and about Hashem, I explained a few questions that some rabbis, they couldn't answer, they did not answer them. Not because they don't know, they know. It's just they let the question for us to answer. And I was so happy. So it was a Hilula for me. A Hilula of who? The Hilula of the Torah. The Hilula of Moshe Rabbeinu who gave us the Torah. So my friend, there is no Hilula of Moshe Rabbeinu. The Hilula of Moshe Rabbeinu is when you study Torah. When you study Torah, Moshe Rabbeinu do a Hilula. Moshe Rabbeinu say, hey, God, don't do my Hilula. I do the Hilula for the Torah that you study for me. You wake up to listen to Torah, I do the Hilula. You just do the Hilula based on the Torah. So, Be'ez Hashem, today and tomorrow, it's Rosh Chodesh Nisan, Adar, Bilshin Nichnas Adar, Marbim Bisa. Layhudim, Layhudim, Aita Ora, Vesimha, Vesason, Vika, Good Shabbos.